Greetings from Istanbul Technical University. I am Botan, the team captain of IT Rover Team. We are proud to announce our 9th generation rover, IT Axel Rover. We are ready for University Rover Challenge 2025.
The chassis, which consists of two parts, the frame and the center column, is made of these called aluminum tubes that provide durability and mobility. In order to maintain balance on terrain surface, the rover has a rocker suspension consisting of a feather differential bar. The brushless DC motors that provide the movement of the rover are located inside the aluminum hubs and are thus isolated from external factors. The rover measures 1.1 meters in length with an overall width of 1 meter, including the wheels. Its height from the ground is 0.3 meters.
The electronics box is the central nervous system of our rover. The system is powered by 42-volt lithium-ion battery, delivering energy to a dual-stage switch and a custom power distribution board. The PDB regulates the various voltage levels, ensuring stable power delivery to all subsystems. The rover's movement is driven by STM32-based motor controllers, which utilize PID algorithms for precise control. Feedback from Hall effect sensors and magnetic encoders ensures accurate RPM and torque adjustments. Safety is paramount. The system has an emergency hard kill switch that instantly shuts down all power.
All edge radio and sensor data is managed by our main vehicle control, while its connection to the rest of the local network is established using TCP and UDP over the internet protocol. For long-range tasks, we rely on 2.4 GHz RF and 900 MHz LoRa module. While 2.4 GHz module handles high bandwidth tasks like video streaming, and 900 MHz module handles the telemetry data.
All our cameras encoded in H265 format to minimize data size, ensuring efficient transmission even in the poor radio conditions. To prevent bottlenecks, microprocessors with hardware accelerators are utilized, enabling low latency and high compression. This approach enhances both efficiency and stability during video transmission, ensuring a seamless communication experience. We are able to visualize both the map and the rover's current position within our user interface.
We designed a 6-axis freedom roboticon powered by custom built SAR mechanism and BLDC motors for precise and efficient performance. To provide the SAR torque by minimizing backlash, we used a belt drive system with custom designed stacked little gearboxes. The belt drive system allowed for precise motor placement, optimizing weight distribution and enhancing overall stability. In order to reduce weight, we designed compact cycloidal reducers and composite materials such as aluminum and carbon fiber into the roboticon. The end effector was designed with highly flexible movement capabilities to adapt to a variety of tasks and operate effectively in all directions.
We used ROS to process data from the sensors on the robotic arm and sent back the results of calculations. Using these results, we tested our manipulator in various real-world scenarios and simulation environments like gazebo. To move the end effector to the desired position and orientation by teleoperation, we calculated inverse kinematic solution using the decoupling method. We used move it to allow the end effector to autonomously reach the position calculated by the Tesseract OCR engine later detection algorithm. With MoveIt, the robotic arm can turn switches on and off, press buttons, open drawers, and perform tasks like typing on a keyboard with ease.
A state machine is implemented to be able to control and check the status of the rover. Localization is achieved by getting the heading of the rover from a dual antenna GNSS configuration and diffusion of the data collected from differential GNSS and IMU sensors. A radar sensor is used for creating point cloud data of the environment, and the cost map is created with this data for optical evidence, and the depth camera is used for search algorithm. Additionally, triple status lights that are even visible under sunlight provide real-time feedback on the rover's operational mode.
Custom trained artificial intelligence algorithms are used to identify bottles and metals. For searching to objects, a probabilistic search algorithm is used with a depth camera.
The rover employs a cyclical search pattern to detect architects from a distance using our newly developed algorithm. A state machine is integrated to monitor and control the rover's status effectively.
The system consists of three main components: Digger analysis and turret system. Digger uses a specially designed shovel with a peristaltic pump to collect and transport soil to test. Inside the shovel, the soil mixes with liquid before passing through a filtering system to prevent contamination prior to analysis. For deeper sampling, the drill system retrieves soil from up to 15 cm below the surface, efficient to transport and releasing the sample as needed. Our design, piezoelectric system, a polymer coated QCM surface, detects private phosphate molecules by generating a signal upon interaction. Glucose detection uses enzyme on white paper, visualizing it RGB. Also, we have developed a computational method to quantitatively assess habitability and potential for life.
Green hydrogen region is used to determine the amino acid types, and organic base region is used for the detection of ATP. The concentration of amino acids and ATP are analyzed via our design cumulative spectrometer. Also, we are developing a nuclear basis detection system that uses fluorescent-based linkage to analyze our spectrometer. Mineral analysis is performed with a deep interval of 785 nanometer advanced spectrometer to mitigate noise from fluorescence emitted by organic soil components. We intend to apply signal processing techniques such as the fast Fourier transform.
We use a depth camera to scale and determine the cardinal directions of the stratigraphic section image, while our high-resolution camera provides detailed close-up views of rock for geological analysis. Onboard sensors measure temperature, humidity, and atmospheric gases to assess environmental conditions. The landing sites, Cretaceous and Jurassic age formations comprise deltaic deposits, ancient fluvial channels, and water-related sedimentary units, exhibiting evidence of transgressive and regressive sequences that reflect past hydrological dynamics.